For the four or five of you who seem to be paying attention to these YouTube videos, I thought that I would bring you up to date in the increasingly, you know, picaresque soap opera that's taking place here in the University Library. Yesterday I received a letter, hand-delivered by one of the campus lawyers. It's a letter that I've been expecting, and it in essence says that because I refuse to do what I was told to do, that is grounds for termination of my employment, and they are moving in that direction. I, out of protest, refuse to do my collection development policies. To me, these policies seem, considering the events that are going on in the university library, to be completely meaningless. I mean, a policy to govern the building of collections when there is, in essence, no money for collections. The dean has diverted any and all money for any and all print resources to, you know, cover the expense and the lavish accoutrements of this new university library. The books that we have are precariously perched on the edge of a dumpster. So it just seems meaningless. But they've taken this as, you know, an opportunity to start the proceedings to have me dismissed. I consider my job to build collections and to promote collections and to preserve collections, and they seem to consider my job to be to throw away books. And I feel that I am upholding the highest professional values of librarianship in not doing what they say. But apparently the very act of not doing what a dean tells you to do, regardless of how around the bend that dean may have gone, is in their minds grounds for dismissal. Recently, and probably most disturbingly, the chair of our reference department, Emma Gibson, resigned that post because they were trying to browbeat her and coerce her, as they've done with others, into writing a letter complaining about me for my personnel file, and she refused to do that. You know, she may not agree with everything I'm saying, but she certainly agrees with a faculty's academic freedom as being sacrosanct, and so she stepped down because of that. And that's just the type of things that they're doing. You know, they're trying to coerce people and pack my personnel file with just as many negative letters as they can find. It's as if here at Cal Poly Pomona, and especially in the University Library, you know, some sort of transportation through time and space has taken place, and we've entered into, I don't know if you know the Superman comic book's bizarro world where everything is ass backwards. You know, black is white, you get the picture. That's what it's like here. Let me give you some examples. You know, I'm a librarian, and it's my job to build collections and to preserve collections and make those collections accessible to our faculty, staff, and students. And that's my job. But the university, you know, is trying to fire me for doing those things and not doing things like throwing books away, making stuff unavailable to students, bizarro. Another example, the dean of the university library has shrouded this entire building, you know, process in secrecy and subterfuge, which is an anathema to what, you know, a library should stand for, which is openness. Our university president you know, doesn't seem to be particularly interested in books and scholarship and research and teaching and learning. Instead, you know, he's interested in rock climbing walls in sports centers. He's interested in Starbucks. He's interested in moving Cal Poly to a ritzier neighborhood. And he's interested in golf courses. Bizarro world. Another development is that I haven't been feeling well lately, especially when I'm at work. Just the act in the morning of walking into this new library building, it fills me with a sense of dread. It makes my chest get tight. There's this feeling of ennui I have about how meaningless this new library is, and a sense of sadness about, you know, what should have been this incredibly joyous, you know, celebration on our campus about, you know, a new intellectual heart being born, about this wonderful new building and all of the services and events and collections that, you know, it has the potential to host. But there's none of that, because under the direction of the dean of the university library, what was once, you know, a really well thought of library has been, you know, systematically, you know, dismantled. And it's just, it's a big old soulless study hall. It's like it's 1957, you know, we're taking a step back instead of a step into the future. It just seems so sad to me, and it's taken a real toll on my health.